All right, guys, if you have in your family those people, big or small, who wear in patches for job, have uniform to go to work with and have patches to it, you know, rank can change if you're talking about military, added patches if you're talking about Boy Scouts, Girl Scouts, or just a simple uniform, what my husband wearing for work. Well, at least once, those insignia has to be sewn to that uniform. And well, how to do it? Most questions. Having tailor shop for almost 30 years, most questions people ask. Most of them come in with question where to put it. Well, if it's for company, certain company, give you about place, just put on the sleeves, for example, yeah? Doesn't matter it's short or long sleeves. Rule, it's go down, probably, like if it's short sleeve, right in the middle of it. Right in the middle of it, distance between the shoulder seam and bottom of sleeves, that's going to be about right place to put patches. If it's long sleeve, usually no more as 2.5 inches from shoulder seam down. Or we're talking if it's more strict, like a patch which is curved along, curved on the top. Those ones going usually more close up to the shoulder seam, like as close as possible, or at least 1/2 inch. I will say 70% of them going about 1/2 inch below shoulder seam, if you're talking about shoulder seams on the sleeves. Well, if it's front patches, usually it will go on the pocket. Yes, you have to rip pocket to put patch to keep pocket functional. You rip pocket, put patch on. Usually it's left pocket because if you have two patches goes on the front, if it's company patches, and for example, one of them is American flag and another one is company patch, flag just keep in mind, simple rule, flag always go on the heart, which is going to be your left pocket. And another one, which is your belongings to that company or so, that's showing, that's go on the right side. On the pocket or above pocket, if it's just a long patch, those ones go in above pocket. Well, name. If it's name and a company patches, no, those usually, we're talking like 70-80% of those, name patch going on the right side and company or belongings where belongings on the left side above pockets. That's a common rules. Now, if it's more strict rules, like military, Boy Scout, Girl Scouts, well, if it's more strict rules, well, you have to go on each website, boys, because rules changing. I cannot give you most common rules right now, because rules changing, you know, uniform changing, not in military, but in Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, uniforms changing all the time. By the way, this new uniform for California Boy Scouts, I was so shocked when they come up with that, because it's an old uniform. It was not flammable polyester. It was some cotton mixed to it. The new one, what they come up with, it's a totally flammable on a tag. People who make that uniform tell you, do not get around fireplaces or any kind of sparks flying in the air. But that's exactly where Boy Scouts goes, right? Wearing those uniforms. They go into forests, they sit by in the campgrounds, by fireplaces, and that was just totally insanity. And if your kid in some organization like that, please check tags. If it says flammable, complain, talk to instructors, and so on. That's what I will do. Well, anyway, rules changing. Well, for any kind of those organizations, rule changing. That's why you have to go on each side, and a bit military, what? Leave it my tailor shop. I just had separate. I just put a ruler. Once I do those patches, I found where they go, distances. I just make picture. You know, for me, it was steady pictures like that because it's old ones. These rules never change. But again, I had separate folder for Marines, separate for Army, for U.S. Navy. As you can see, all those pictures with rules, how far from this seam, how far from this seam. You can do the same. Once you found on the website that rule, where that patch go, first of all, what I want to tell you, if we're talking about military patches and or any kind of patches, I do suggest you to go to professionals. Why? Because patch have certain thickness to it. Your needle will not go through those thickness. And you try to put some glue tape on it or glue there, hot glue on it. I saw all of it, all kind of ways what people try to put those patches. They end up losing that, those patches, and they have to pay more money to refill it. Or it's just so ugly and it's never come up straight. No, well, if you can, find those professionals who still do it, tailors, seamstresses who still does it, but you have to provide them with instructions. It's up to you. Don't expect them to know all of it. My customer did expect me to know all of it because I was in business so long. No, well, I knew all this kind of rules for all kind of military, even for vintage. Like this is a vintage uniform for special SEAL teams, special forces. Even I did plenty of them because a lot of collectors in my area, like 3 collectors I had with military uniforms, and they really trust me with all this. Plus old patches for collectible uniforms, they come up without finishing, without fancy finishing, and I had to kind of make sure what sometime with hands but they was more soft. I can sew them by hands. No, well, especially before World War II patches, they was really soft. No, well, those rules kind of, you have to go to professionals who do it for many years, because to find place, instructions where these guys goes, collectible patches, collectible uniforms, you really have to dig museum sites and documentaries, you know, really, really not easy to know those things. But, well, if you deal with today's military, websites, go on the websites, they will give you, usually when your family member got promoted on certain rank or given first time military uniform, they will give you little instructions on the go, a little book on the go, where to go, where those patches go. But as they grow in a rank, it's kind of or some fancy parade uniform, you have to really know where it goes. And I had many Navy captains, which was so many stripes on those parade uniforms. And you really have to know how to do it properly. You have to go to professionals, obviously. But believe or not, who gave me most of troubles when I was doing those patches in tailor shop? It was not military whatsoever. It was Girl Scouts and Boy Scouts, believe or not. Because most strict rules of all, most variety of patches, and it was just crazy to work for them. No, well, Girl Scouts, what you do? Once you went on that website, print it out. Print it out like I had my instructions, as you can see. Print it out all in colors, okay? Where it's go, print it once, and keep it on the site. Because, you know, right now when they're starting, they having only few patches, and then more and more coming. You need all of it. Don't waste your time to go every time new patch arrive in your life to go online again and look for it. Just print it out. By the way, if you do have courage to start doing military patches on your own, at least make pictures like what I did. At least make pictures, put ruler where you put them, make picture with your phone, don't have to be camera pictures like mine. Put that distance on a ruler and save on your phone what next time you don't not gonna waste time to look for it again. Boy Scouts, that's a different category of people. This is worst things of all, okay? They have whole booklets like this one, Insignia. See how long I was in business, started collecting these books from 2005, was in business even 10 years before it. No, well, anyway, they do have all these websites. And again, they have all kind of instructions and the whole booklets of it. Print it out, but you're not going to waste your time. Well, usually, you know, this certain amount of patches which is go on a short. And most of them is common. Usually Boy Scouts not making to those nuts to put here, because this is kind of complicated one, and you have to know how to deal with those nuts, but very few people getting them. Most of them is just number of unit, where they belong, train, not trade, American flag already short come with American flag, and all this stuff, it's very easy to do it. Again, when you make sure when you put something like that on a pocket, make sure your pocket is functional. What it's mean? Any go on a pocket, rip pocket off, of your garment, put patch on and then stitch back it back. If you do by yourself, or demand of professional who will do it, keep pocket functional, because boys does use pockets, right? Girls have bags, girls have boys have pockets. They do use pockets. And new uniform, you know, in California, they come in even with pockets for cell phone on the sleeve. No, well, they use all of it. And, well, flap on the pocket. Again, if you put this big patch on the flap on the pocket, this pocket become not functional. You can use that pocket. Make sure you sew that way, what all these pockets will be functional for Boy Scouts. And again, all instructions online. When you're going about sashes, no, well, sashes, you always see these little instructions that come in like that, with little instructions. And make pictures. Every time you put these arrows, those little patches like that, make sure you really, really make pictures with your phone, at least, but next time you're not digging the same website. What you put this time, you know, he getting more arrow, you know which place that arrow goes, right? What you're not gonna be looking for that over and over again. Sashes, you know, I know that rule don't exist anymore, used to be old rule. What those merit patches, which is counting for Eagle, to graduate to Eagle, Eagle Scout, they have silver board right here. Other optional merit badges have green roll around it, roll of thread around it. And usually when we did this job for sashes, eagle patches, which is required ones, will go in the middle, lined up on your sash. And this one's with green circle will go on the sides, okay? Doesn't matter how many he got it. If he got only green ones, okay, leave this only three here in silver and rest of green position here. Maybe to the end of the patch, until he will start collecting his obligated Eagle merit badges. No, well, that's going to be, I know this rule is gone already, I believe like 8 years ago, but they can be mixed. But it's kind of visually very nice if you put a silver, all silver here and all green ones is here. Now, many people coming to me and with fun patches, you know, all kind of fun patches, places what they go, things what they do, Boy Scouts, and ask me where to put them. They're not going on uniform. They're not going on this on obligate, because this is obligations, what you have on your sash, what you have on your shirt. Everything else, fun patches, they're not going anywhere here. They will go on a jacket. Only jackets. How you place them? You place them, usually I place them on the back. And I kind of put, start from building up this pyramid from bottom, at least 3-4 on the bottom, and then go and build up that. And tell to parents, if you sew for somebody else, or you parents on your own doing this job, collect these fun patches. Don't sew each one. Because, you know, if you collect them, at least 10 of them, and then sew 10 at once, you position better. Like a little one between big ones, you know, this one is higher, but kind of two lines come up together. You can position better then, as randomly you will put each one. Now let's go to sewing machine and I will show to you how to handle that patch under sewing machine if you decide to do on the own. All right, guys, now we buy sewing machine. And if you have patch which is already existed on your uniform and you need to take it off and put new one on or salvage old one for some other reason, to give to somebody, always good to salvage whenever it is. Well, you have to take this one off first before you put new one on. No, well, let me show you how to rip first, because many people make these mistakes. It's very common mistake, and by just doing by scissors or try to rip it with whenever not careful, they cut this little embroidering. See this little embroidering going around patches, every one half of it. It's like a embroidered edge over. Done, of course, now with automatic embroidering machine when they make this patch. No, well, what it's mean? It's mean when you cut any of those little threads, all the threads will pop up. And all this edge start running. And you probably saw that already. No, well, be very careful when you're ripping it. What to do? Instead picking up the stitching from front, always turn inside out and pick up few stitching from this side, just like that. Don't have to do too much, just about 1 inch of that distance, just to begin from something, okay? Then go back on this side, and here you have already something going on, something open. Now it's easy with trimming scissors like I have, manicure scissors, or simply razor to start ripping and do it all the time. I prefer with razor, of course, but when you do with razor, just a regular razor you got in Home Depot, any kind of store will, household store will have it. Just pull on the parts, make sure you pull in like that. What you're not cutting close, not to this part, not to this part, because if a razor sharp enough new razor, you can cut either one of them. Just snap on the thread, that's it. And then under pull, the thread will pull out by itself. And then what you need to do, just clean that patch from garbage and put on some other garment, or let me show to you how to put a new one on. All right, now when you have your patch and you have uniform to put on, where patches goes? Usually on the sleeves and on the front, right? No, well, let me show to you how it's going on the sleeves. I just have this cut out piece of uniform. I don't care holding, but in your case, it's going to be holding your uniform. Yeah, if you're lucky, you have short sleeves. It's easy to work with that. If you're not lucky, you're going to have all long sleeve and you need to sew in a tube. No, well, it's mean you have to do this kind of motions. And first of all, where to put it? Let me repeat to you what I already just told you in the beginning of video. Usually this company patches going on the sleeves about 1/2 inch away from shoulder seam. Pay attention, because this is what shoulder seam come to sleeve, right here, center. As you can see, this patch been placed there, and that's exactly right way how it was. Forward a little bit, because this epaulettes on the uniforms, if you have them, they going a little bit forward to make sure when person staying facing you, you can see in insignia. Okay, that's why it's done. Now, well, if you don't have that requirements, in that case, you will put right here, center it right here, and 1/2 inch down. That's a common distance, 1/2 inch down on the top of sleeve. If it's short sleeve, it's different. It's between your end of sleeve and here. That's how usually it's does. Unless company will tell you still put it 1/2 inch here. Again, you have to kind of figure up and talk with your supervisor if what's going on with your patches, okay? But this is a common rule. No, well, 1/2 inch from here. And if you have epaulette, going right centered by epaulette, because if you center not, it's gonna look funny. And it does have reason. I just explained to you what kind of reason you have. Now you have to in order to sew, don't intend, make sure what, as you can see, this is kind of curved edge, and you have to have this parallel edge to the exactly parallel to end of your sleeve. You cannot just go like that guessing, because that's what will be visible, or this one this way guessing. You can kind of pay attention, 1/2 inch here, and this end, straight end, has to be exactly parallel to end of sleeve, whenever it is long or short. Now, do not intend to sew anything unless you pin it. If you put this little glue tape here, and then or masking tape, and you start sewing, it's gonna slide right over. Trust me, it's never gonna happen. Your best choice, if you can afford it, to go to professional seamstress or tailor to do that, because your machine can handle it, your domestic machine can handle that easy, no question about it. But the sliding thing, by the time what you finish, is gonna be all crooked, and you're not gonna like it. And if that person not gonna like it, it's not gonna meet requirements, because it's all about requirements. Now, you can see pins. This is a tailor pins. This is a short one. It's about only 1 inch one. For patches, I suggest to use 1.5 inch long ones, like this ones. 1.5 inch long ones, because it's otherwise it's very hard to work with that, to pin it. And what you do, you get in these pins, you get them online for nothing, and well, you kind of place it again, like I just explained to you, and then pin it. Not too close, because you're going to run here under your machine with your foot, and your foot is about 1/2 inch wide. Not too close. Far away from it. Far away from it. And what you need to do, at least 2 pins. At least 2 pins, make sure what your patch is not going nowhere. Not going to slide any direction whatsoever. Depend how big is the patch and how complicated shape of it. Sometime 3 will be minimum. And then what you do, you start, of course, you match thread. In patches, usually I tell you what's the matter, because usually when we stitch, what's the matter for us to match color, to match our garment from bobbin, from under, because that's the one when we torn, torn, we usually sew from this side. When we torn, that's the one will be visible. But in patches, it's different. What color it matches to match color on your patch, what you're stitching will be not visible. In this case, it's a black one, of course. I do have already thread up my machine in blue one. I'm not going to change. I'm too lazy woman for it to change the wall. But for you, I'm telling you, it has to be black and close to the this embroidering. As you can see, I'm showing to you this little embroidering. You just follow that and your stitching will be not visible. Another thing, if you stitch in patches, make sure you put on a wide stitch, not a super wide, but like about to the very, very maximum wide will be 70% of that. That's that setting what you change, because different machines have different numbers. I'm not going to tell you numbers. In my case, it will be number 4 wide, and right now it's 3.5. I'm not going to mess with my machine adjustments. I'm going to keep it like that. In your case, it can be anything. If your maximum is 9, you can grind on a 7 or on a 6, something like that. Now, well, let's start stitching. And let me go out what you can see better and position my phone better. Okay, you just get under, start it somewhere, always begin your stitching with needle down, always begin your stitching with needle down. As you can see, your pin not on the way whatsoever. And all what you need to do, don't push, don't pull, let machine do all those movement, because that's the machine, remember those T's which is under over there, that's a moving tease. It's gonna move machine, any machine gonna move your job by itself. No, well, let's just hold like that, not much to it, and kind of hold your one arm, one hand on the wheel, especially in my case, because it's a speedy industrial machine what I'm working. But because every patch have those curves and turns, make sure you approach that curve and turn like I do, by walking, not actually pushing pedal much, just by walking. And then you can push pedal, get to another corner, and then push pedal again. Oh, see, I did mistake. Good, I'm happy I did mistake, because it's a speedy industrial machine, and I want to make mistake. I want you to know what you're allowed to make mistakes. It's okay to make mistakes. None of us is perfect. Only God is perfect, and He created us not perfect way. And if you're reaching for anything perfect in your life, your look, your job, your partner, anything like that, you have to realize, as soon you realize, as younger age, in younger age, it's better you will be in life. Nothing perfect and nothing will be ever perfect in your life. Well, you have to learn how to live with that. So that's perfect if you make mistake. How else you can learn? Best ways of learning is by making mistakes, right? Now I'll go back, go a little bit back, half inch below where you started, and walk. What I supposed to do first time to begin? I did not. That's why it's get off and well, go again. In my case, I have to go very slow because it's a speedy industrial machine what I'm working on. In your case, you don't have to go too slow. When you get to your beginning, again, only pass like about half inch where you started. Done deal. Done deal. By the way, when you pull on that thing, don't pull this way. Most of the time, put this way or back, because otherwise it's gonna shake your needle and not good for machine to pull forward to you or on the side. Go that way. In industrial case, machine case is fine, but in your domestic machine, it's matter. It's matter. No, well, that's it. Cut off this all trashes. You get your patch. And only now, you can get rid of these pins. If you don't have these pins to begin with, okay, you can use safety pin to do the same job. But it's going to be more, be careful, more careful. You can do this way. Going to be much more not easy to push it in, because patch have thickness. And then position this way, what is going to be on your way of your stitching. You can do that as well. And, well, happy sewing, guys. And I hope it's helping you. And thank you for watching. Thank you for your time. More is 200 videos. I believe like 240 already online. No, well, please go check, click on that name of the channel, which is starts from perfect word. And channel page pop up, and you can go on on the playlist, just scroll down to figure out what channel all about, and maybe something will interest you. And if it is, subscribe, but you will not miss, because much more coming on the channel. Thank you for your time.